Welcome to Access to Experts podcast, where business success secrets are revealed from world-class experts. And now your host, Debbie Allen.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Access to Experts. I'm super excited to have my new friend here with us today. He's going to teach you a lot about being a successful entrepreneur. Jay Fiset is a already very successful entrepreneur. He's been working on lots of different projects for a long time. He's a risk taker, which is also really important as you're an entrepreneur. He likes to take risks, really off the edge, probably. And I think that's probably a good thing when you're an entrepreneur. He's a leader who reaches his goals by helping others reach their goals. And we know as experts, that's the thing we want to do. He has over 20,000 hours experience conducting personal development seminars. His company, Creators Code, is a leading seminar company that provides workshops promoting self-awareness and stimulating personal growth. And he's also the founder of JVology, where I kind of get to know him. You're going to learn more about JVology, why joint venture partners are critically important for your success to build a 6-7-figure business. You can't be on an island by yourself. You have to have joint venture partners. And some of you may go, what is that? Well, I'll have Jay explain all that to you. But to really not find just partners, find really quality people. And that's how I met Jay, was through another mastermind of JV partners. And so I'm thrilled to have him here. And you're going to learn a lot from him today. Welcome, Jay.
I'm so happy to be here, Debbie. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, so great. So I know that you've been doing personal development for a long time. Tell me how that you led into wanting to absorb yourself in personal development, wanting to do those type of events, write books on that. And then we'll move into the JVology because you're a multifaceted man.
I have an odd and unusual background and a range of experience that sometimes people raise their eyebrow at. But here's the long and the short of it is that I ran a construction company in Calgary, Alberta. I had a business partner who was one of the grumpiest human beings I ever met in my entire life, Polish fellow. But he was very good at what he did. And he knew construction, he knew selling, he knew building. He was very, very good, but not a happy human being. And I go in my office one day. And it was a Tuesday, and he said, I'm going to be away on holidays for Wednesday all the way through. I'll be back on Monday, which is unusual because he worked like a madman. And fine, go to town. He comes back on Monday, and I swear to God, Debbie, he was like not walking on the ground. He was like floating about 2 inches off the air. Mm. He was smiling. He was making jokes. And you have to understand, I was very young when this transpired. And I'm trying to figure out what was going on with
right,
this.
You just thought he got laid. I know.
Yes.
That's the first thing that came to your mind.
It is true.
It is and just.
and that it'll wear off right away, right? He'll be back to his grumpy self. Now, in the week that followed, that entire week, we had more fun together. We sold more than we'd ever done. And our business had done better than it had. That's the best week of our entire business. Wow. So at the end of that week, we're at a little sort of pub. And I say to him, like, Andy, what the hell happened? It's like aliens took over your body. Like, what is going on? You have got to tell me. And he takes a sip of his beer and he says, I took a course. It was very powerful. Take it. And at the time, I'm like 19 years old, almost 20. And what I heard him say was, I took a sales course. Take it and we'll make more money. Because that's what I was primarily motivated by.
Right.
And so I show up this course, which I think is a sales course. It is anything but, and I'm not the sharpest knife in the drawer. It takes me a couple of days to figure that out. And, but what transpires is it transforms how I see myself. It transforms what I believe my role in the world is. It transforms my relationships with literally everyone in my world and in my family. And I ultimately went back to school. Years later, was asked to come back and take their facilitator training, which I did, then bought the company, and then spent the next 26 years leading those courses for about 40,000 people from all over God's green earth. So, yeah, you know, as most things in my life have been the best, it has been an unusual serendipitous sort of listening to the universe and the people around me path.
Right. That's not a typical class of people that get into personal development and have that much experience in it. You're just like, okay, it's already running. I got something out of it. Let me buy it. But that's the true entrepreneur in you going, okay, I can do this and I can be an expert at this. And then maybe, you know, just totally get into it. and be known for that.
Yeah. And what transpired, just so you know, like when I went to work for the organization, I was the 18th employee there, the youngest, the least experienced. I was not the person who should have ended up buying the thing, to be perfectly honest. And yet,
young. Yeah, you're really young.
Many thought too young. But it was that, I think both combination of boldness, dedication, and ignorance all rolled into one that allowed it to actually occur.
I can relate to that. You have to have a little of that as an entrepreneur anyways. Yes. So, yeah. So now that's, you know, was another company and now it's Creators Code. And so you still run those along with JVology?
So we licensed that content years and years ago. And so I do very, very little with it personally. That said, probably once or twice a year, you know, old grads rattle me to bug me to run a course. We were about to, now that COVID is sort of, you know, slowing down a little bit and we can actually go into rooms again, I do have one scheduled, which, you know, this is an interesting piece about the impact of that course. We actually had a grad who passed away some years ago and left a inheritance to the organization to deliver the course for free for 100 people. Oh, and, you know, that was just a beautiful thing when you consider what it meant to him to do that. So we have this, you know, what we call the Robert Moody Memorial Program coming up as soon as we can put 100 people in a room at the same time here in Canada.
Sure. And the thing is that, you know, any entrepreneur that is really someone that is an expert and wants to teach other people, they've done the personal development work. You know, I've been in so many of those when I was reading one of your other intros, Walking on Fire, doing this, like I could name all of them except skydiving, but pretty much all of them, like in a weekend, we're going to go do all these crazy things, but it does change you over time. And that is really part of it. I think if you want to be somebody that really connects with other people, and that's obviously your brilliance, Jay, because, you know, early on you learned, you know, 19, 20 years old, hey, it's great when you have a partner and you can do something together. You can go faster together with like-minded. He wasn't like-minded at first. He shifted and the business took off. So tell me a little bit more about how you got into joint venture partners. And first of all, let's tell people that are listening to this what a joint venture partner is, because a lot of people haven't heard of that before.
Yes. So a joint venture partner, and by the way, I'm going to use my definitions. Lots of, you know, there are legal versions of joint ventures in real estate. That's not what I'm talking about. So joint ventures, from my perspective, is when one or more people or organizations come together. They combine their network, their wisdom, their experience, their resources to create a product, service, or an offering for their clients that solves a particular problem. And based upon what the contributions are, there is a split of the rewards at the end of that that helps people grow and scale their businesses. So I like to think of it, you know, when we do joint ventures well, two things happen in our business. Number one, we create a steady stream of perfectly qualified leads for free. And we create a recurring passive income stream that, you know, levels off the entrepreneurial ups and downs that makes entrepreneurship easy. And it is just as simple as this. And I want to be clear that I'm broadening that there's sort of three categories. There's affiliate marketing. It's like you buy something, they say, hey, if you like it, here's a link, and you write a blog, you put in your email, you do whatever. That's the simplest and easiest thing in the universe. No relationships required. Then there is sort of the middle ground, what I would call the actual joint ventures. Then that's a project that generally has a beginning, a middle, and end. So that could be a course, that could be a program, that could be a book launch, that could be a live event, that could be any of those sorts of things where we say, hey, let's come together and do this. And then if we want to continue doing it, we'll say, hell yes. If we didn't like how it went, we might wash our hands and carry on. And then the third and most sort of sophisticated, and what I love the best and what I'm looking for virtually always is ways to do what we call strategic partnerships that include embedded content that help, you know, anticipate what our clients need next, build a pathway and a referral network that actually really makes a difference. And when done well, what transpires is this: we stop being just a service provider and we become a trusted advisor to our clients and to our community. And that's where everything gets easy.
Most definitely. That's the thing. And it's like, you can't be everything to everyone. So you know, having these partners, and like I said, really quality partners that really speak to what your following needs. So, you know, what you do, Jay, is like you help people come to an event, learn how to actually create these. You're creating them there on the spot. And so you've embraced that as far as that is your expertise in teaching people how to do this. Because most people have no idea and they're trying to do it all by themselves and you can't. And then when you're in the expert world, the great thing is we're all experts on something and all of us have a lot of times a very narrow niche. And you go, hey, that's something else I can teach. And so here's the other thing that you said, Jay, was a key is that trusted relationship. So if I already have a trusted relationship with you, Jay, and I say, hey, anything Jay does, it's quality, it's cool. You're going to have an awesome time. You're going to learn a ton. Go follow Jay. You're going to more likely follow Jay if you never heard of him before because I referred him and the same thing back on my end. Yes. So that's the beauty of it, right?
Yes. That
finding, like you said, you can take out ads, you can push your marketing and sales all you want, but a relationship like that just goes, it's kind of like skyrockets the whole opportunity.
It really does. And we teach, sort of a proprietary method that we call the upstream downstream model. And I think one of the places where sometimes people go a little awry in the joint venture space in the joint venture world is they're thinking like, so who has the same target market that I have? And often they end up with a little bit of overlap that causes some friction and some perceived, I don't necessarily believe there's truly competition and perceived competition. Mm-hmm. But our model is different. It's that we're not looking for a partner that has the same traffic as we do. We are looking for a partner and this is for upstream. These are the people that could send the best clients to us. We're looking for a partner that either causes the problem we solve, reveals the problem we solve, or diagnoses the problem that we solve in their little magic trick, in their particular niche. And from that perspective, for example, like we've got partners like Thinkific, Alina Vincent, all those sorts of things, who they help people get courses, programs, challenges up and running. And then folks are like, well, wait a sec, now I need more people. Yes, of course right. You do. You should come to JVology, where we'll introduce you to 100 partners out of JVology Live, or 500 partners in our community, and we'll get you more traffic. So that whole who causes, reveals, or diagnoses the problem that you solve, those are your best upstream partners. And it's a different thing that's like, hey, who's got the same folks I serve, which usually leads people to looking at people that are doing stuff similarly. And that's just, that's a recipe for frustration.
Yes, exactly. But there's always an extra piece. Like you said, like, you know, with my expert positioning, I get them positioned, you know, here's your brand and here's your website and here's some skills and you're all set to go. But now you're going to need partners and now you're going to need to learn how to do challenges and now you learn how to do courses. And so that's the idea of passing them on to other experts that truly teach that and own it. And the big important lesson here is know what you own as an expert, so that you have a lane and everybody knows you as that lane. And they think, when they think Jay, they think joint venture guy, right? Like they don't have to remember your name. They don't have to remember the name of the business, but they need to know like how they relate to you.
Yes.
So let's walk through the JVology. You know, that was always a live event where people came to a live in-person event before COVID.
Yes.
Right. And you're putting hundreds of people in the room. You're connecting people together. How did you pivot that to virtual and make it so successful without having that networking one-on-one connection? Because it is very much was that.
I have to tell you, Debbie, I was worried first time that we did it online. Like I was genuinely worried.
I get you. <I'm> in there.
And it was a fascinating experience. So I was, first and foremost, I was just transparent with the community, which is COVID's here and we're going to adapt. And I don't know exactly how it's going to work, but we are going to do everything in our power to feature, present, connect you with the people who are in the room virtually, which is different than being able to sit at the same table, shake their hand, give them a hug, buy them a drink in the lounge, you know, all those sorts of things. It's a different experience. And here's what I hoped for. I hoped that we would get like 80% as good of connections and exposure online. Now, here's the crazy thing that happened. This boggled me. And in hindsight, it makes sense. I just didn't get it. Here's what occurs is actually the connections, the introductions and the partners are actually, please hear this, it boggled my brain, probably 3 to 5 times stronger online than in person.
Really?
And at first I'm like, what the hell? How is that possible? But it soon became very, very clear that what happens in person is that people fall into a comfort zone quite quickly. So they end up sitting at a similar table.
True. Yeah.
They end up having a little bit of a click with people that they connect with. Now we still, the JV invitations, they're going to interact with absolutely everyone, but there's this social component of conditioning that basically if somebody comes to a JVLG live, filter, sort, all the rest of it, and they probably leave with maybe 7 to 15 really solid folks that they can connect with and that there's a something's going to happen with. Right. But online, here's what happens. A bunch of what I'm going to call the social awkwardness disappears. The fact that people can see someone and look them up quickly on Facebook and send them a Facebook message. The fact that they can share a booking link in a 5-minute chit chat, as opposed to it's like, hey, I'll make sure that I send you something and we'll follow up and we'll get to all that.
Then it sits on your desk. You're right sitting there with technology and they want to be doing something too, multitasking.
Exactly. So wow, what transpires, cool. I literally have had a dear friend of mine, Mustafa, who's also in JVMM. I don't know if you, so Mustafa was in one of our very first joint venture JVLG lives. And so we sort of gave him his start in that domain. And he was at a JVLG live, I think it was 2 times ago. And Saturday morning, he texts me, says, look, brother, I don't want to seem ungrateful. And I don't want you to wonder where I am. It's just that I've booked 37 meetings in the first day and a half. I can't be here longer. I'm jammed. He said, so it's like, thank you. This is the best thing in the entire universe in a day and a half, 37 meetings. And he told me a number. I wish I remember. I think it was like, I think I just made $250,000. So have a good rest of the course.
And that's the thing, Jay, that's why I wanted to have you on the podcast now, because I was in a position where I was looking for strategic type of partners in like a networking group, a high level one, paid $10,000 to one. That wasn't the right fit. Got involved in another one, was in there for over a year and a half, wasn't the right fit. And then, this online mastermind, we don't hang out together. We connect together. We do the calls and, everybody gets it. Cause when they're taught it, like you teach it, it's like you teach them how to get it, how to make the connections, what to do with those. And then having your different offers, cause you get on the phone, you have a conversation and see where it all goes. And we end up doing business together because we all want to support each other and learn from each other as well. Cause you're at that level. But I realized that this is a game changer, the whole online stuff, because people that really want to build a huge online following, they can't do it just by themselves because you're putting out the same information. It might be fabulous information, but it's the same information with the same people, and getting new people in from those trusted advisors is the answer. And you can do it all from your home. You don't even have to.
You absolutely can. And I still, by the way, I love the live bits. Like we have, in fact, I have no idea if this would work, but Dove and I have been talking about doing a little joint venture with the community to bring people to our, what we call the JVology Summit in Cabo San Lucas in February, because it would be so great to meet some of those folks in person. And it'd be, I don't think you're terribly far from Cabo San Lucas, but anyway, we'll talk about that another time. But it is, I don't know about you, but I love the efficiency of being online with people who know what's going on, but there is a different texture.
Connection. The body language, everything, people hanging out, having a drink, like, hey, we're not looking at, and I get what you're saying. And I don't mean to interrupt what you're saying there, but I mean,
we're on the same page. Yeah.
It's that you go, hey, I met Jay. He's going to be a friend and a partner in business some way for the rest of our lives. Yeah. I mean, that's the thing. That's like, you can imagine having 10 of those, 20 of those or whatever. Right.
Well, let's talk about that. Cause in fact, at JVology Live, the objective, so we teach the upstream downstream model, and there's a little worksheet that is 10 upstream partners and 10 downstream partners. If they are the correct partners, they will add a zero to your bottom line. So if you made $10,000 last year, you can make $100,000 this year. If you made $100,000 last year, you can make $1 million this year. And that is not marketing and, BS hyperbole. Those are based on case studies and real experiences. So quite literally, we go through that process. And the aim is to fill out who are my top 10 partners in terms of my upstream and who are my top 10 downstream. And when that actually connects at a meaningful manner. And by the way, let's be clear, not everyone is going to be a perfect match. But you have a filtering mechanism and a filtering tool to see what it is and to see how it might unfold. And we quite literally send people home in 3 days with, at times, well, Mustafa was like in a day and a half or 36, but generally speaking, the bare minimum is 20 partners to book podcasts with, do email swaps with, to do a Facebook Live with, to speak on somebody's stage or event, to, you know, all of those pieces. And good Lord, it is astounding. But I wanted to just cycle back to that in-person thing. I think, and maybe it's just me, because I spent 35 years in classrooms, heart-to-heart, face-to-face, belly-to-belly. But I'm kind of itching for a good old face-to-face again, I got to tell you.
Yeah, well, it's definitely a different connection. And I've been doing live events and bigger events for 15 years, you know, so part of me is going, I'm kind of embracing this virtual world much more with JV partners, because I like that. But I like to have that choice. That's financial freedom and choice of how you want to do business. So if you say, you know, I want to go to one live event or do a live event, or I want to be online, either way, you can do it. But walk us through a case study. I know you've got Mustafa, and he's brilliant. He's at a high level expert, right?
He's working, man.
Yeah. So let's talk about a case study of somebody that's like kind of a newbie. They've started their expert business, or they're a coach or something, a speaker. They've got in this world and they've only been in a year or two. They feel like they're newer, and they feel a little intimidated by going into this room and creating partnerships, but they did, and they had a success. So if you can think of somebody's name, it comes to your mind.
I can think of a whole bunch, but I'll tell you the person that I want to focus on. And in fact, I invited him into JVMM with Dove as well. And his name is James Lamb, and he is a Calgarian as well. I met him, I was speaking at one of those sort of breakfast morning things as a favor to an associate of mine. And James jumped on a plane and went to San Diego, which was our last live in-person JVology. And when he tells the story, he talks about he had a business that wasn't working, a business partner he had to get rid of, and was frankly like on the tail end of credit available on his credit cards. And he chose to, number one, go to San Diego. Number two, purchased our one-year guiding program, which we call Flow. And it is a spectacular, high-touch, high-level, high-committed program. But here's the thing, what I love about him. JVology has two core values. The first of which is this, is that a joint venture is a game of I'll go first, which means let me contribute to you. Let me figure out what's relevant to you. Let me actually become significant to you. Let me lay the foundation of, as you said earlier, becoming a friend, not just a business partner. Building a relationship, not just a transaction. So this idea of a joint venture is a game of I'll go first, we take really, really seriously. So that's our first value. The second value is that we are better together, which means that the lone wolf entrepreneur model we think is dumb.
doesn't work anymore. It's just not effective.
100%. And I'm not sure it ever really was, but I think that, you know, in the days when we weren't so connected online and all those sorts of things, is that it was easier for people to BS about their circumstance. But anyway,
I think people that you saw were really super successful. You saw them, but you didn't see all the people that were behind them. You just didn't see it. We know that they were there.
Yes. And let's also be clear about this. And if we're talking about the coaching training world, which we are in terms of James in this example, is that there were a handful of high level sort of folks, and then pretty much nobody. And now there's an entire, you know, if we were thinking of it as a ladder of ascension, there's the A's, the B's, the C's, the D's, the E's, the F's, the G's. And there's an entire industry that for the most part didn't exist when I started in the coaching space, you know, after doing the personal development things 22 years ago. Like that was just not something that existed. Anyway, James, why I tell you those values is that James epitomized a joint venture is a game of I'll go first. And he contributed, connected, built relationships, stood by a ton of folks, beginners. And by the way, we categorize our to help people know what to do. There's willing and eager, ready and refining, and experienced pros. He was starting at the willing and eager in this new space. It was a brand new business. And he lived this idea of a joint venture is a game of I'll go first. He built meaningful relationships. He stood by people in all three of those areas. And this is the beautiful part about this. He went from quite literally zero in the other business, which was just not working well, to strong mid six figures in under 12 months. Mm-hmm. In under 12 months. And totally on track to break seven figures this year. So he's a good example of actually, even when he was at JVLG Live, he didn't even have a program. He came to JVLG Live trying to reinvent his old business and became perfectly clear. It's like, I'm not dragging my unwilling partner along. I'm going to actually create something completely from scratch that is new and six figures inside of a year. It'll be seven figures, I would wager, by the end of this year or next. So James just did it right and he built the relationships. And this is the thing that I want people to understand. Lots of folks think it's like, well, I'll do the joint ventures when my book is done, my digital program is done, when my course is designed, all that stuff. That is completely bass backwards. Build the relationships first, and then you put the product, service, or experience in the distribution channel, not the other way around.
Yeah, relationships are the key of everything. You know, I've learned that when I started my, I've been an entrepreneur like yourself, like 19, and bought into my family business. My first business venture was when I was 30, though, bought into a business that lost money. And I'm like, how do I turn this around? I end up getting into a group of 13 other retailers. It was a retail clothing store, and then grew it, you know, massively. But I had no idea. I was absolutely clueless. They helped me. So that made me go, okay, they're mentors, but they're also partners because we'd share everything. And then I remember, you know, one of my first books I wrote was called Confessions of Shameless Self-Promoters. And I didn't know the heavy hitter. I knew of the heavy hitters as I followed them. I went, you know, followed Dan Kennedy and Joe Vitale and, you know, everybody that had a name back at that time. And I invited them to be in the book. So that was like my collaboration. Then when I started doing the live events, they would come and speak. Otherwise they, you know, they would not have known me. I wasn't a player back then. So I know you don't have to be, you know, you don't have to check all these boxes to get the right people. And I think early on, like you said, from this example that you gave in this case study, he was eager. He was hungry, was a sponge, that enthusiasm. And it was like, well, how can I help you kind of thing? You know, it's that it builds those relationships.
He gave without keeping score. And that's one of the other things that sometimes I'll just say it as clear as I can. If this is a part of your worldview, if you're listening to this, don't come to JVLG because you won't fit here, which is he gave without keeping score. And I have folks who sometimes show up because we do JVs and all sorts of things. Sometimes the, what I'm going to call the wrong people show up, which is I gave first to five people and nobody's given first to me yet. It's like, well, isn't that interesting?
They don't play well in the sandbox. That's what I say. And I had actually, you know, one of our JV partners that we both have, like in our group, is David Newman. Yes. And he just sent me an email one day and he goes, I'm doing one sentence. Do you want to play in the sandbox? And I was like, that's brilliant. Cause that is really what it is. Like those people that you can trust to play in the sandbox that do even similar things that you trust, they're trusted advisors, you know?
Yeah, without a doubt. And I just genuinely love that. And it is one of the things we talk about this a lot at JVLG Live of what we call the JV mindset. And it starts with abundance. So him inviting you into his sandbox, that was a foundation of abundance. That is, there's more than enough for all of us. We all have unique expertise. We all can come together and weave our network, wisdom, experiences, and resources together in something that will be better for our clients. And that to me is that foundation of we're better together. And if we can truly step into that, honest to God, miracles occur. Like where we really got our feet wet with this was our brand Mastermind to Millions, where we helped coaches, authors, experts, entrepreneurs, position, launch, and lead mastermind groups. And we went from zero, a brand that didn't exist, to $2.6 million in 14 months. And it was all from joint ventures. Now, I should qualify this just to be clear, because that isn't entirely true. So the brand didn't exist and we went to $2.6 million in 14 months. But what's not included in that example is I spent 12 to 16 months prior to deciding what that brand was going to be, actually contributing to a bunch of high-level partners. So Lisa Sasevich, Justin Livingston, Bill Barron, like I just served and supported and built relationships and became relevant to them. So that by the time we actually said, this is what we're doing, I had a lineup with some of the biggest names in that community waiting and wanting to participate. So gang, and I say this again for it, you don't need to know even what your product, service, or experience is going to be, but you do need to know how to build relationships and how to actually frame those possibilities.
Yeah, that was huge. What you said there, it's like, you didn't have to wait till you figured it out. And that's how I started seeing you, you know, on some of those other stages. And I started seeing you do your own events. And it just took us a while to connect. And I'm glad we did. So let's go dig into the JVology. Tell me what that whole experience, you know, because it's going to be online, right?
Yes,
so absolutely. Is it 2 days or 3 days?
we rounded up a little bit to like 3.5 days. So what it looks like is that the evening before we start, we do first and foremost an afternoon mastermind. And that mastermind is really designed at helping people get perfectly clear about what will make these 3 days a home run for them. And the beautiful part about joint ventures is the concept of what we're doing never changes. Like that's a truism. Build meaningful relationships, figure out the upstream, downstream, come up with a generous and win-win offer and invitation and bring it to the world. I mean, let's be clear. That doesn't sound particularly full of rocket science. That said, if you're in the, what we're going to call the willing and eager stage, which is your offer isn't quite refined yet, your pages aren't necessarily working quite yet, you haven't come up with a bundle that really moves people, your affiliate systems aren't set up yet. So if you're in that spot, there's a different pathway to make that work than if you're ready and refining, which is I have all those things working. Sure. What I just need is more traffic. So what we do is we really help people identify where are they at, what would be a home run. So at that mastermind, and it's spectacular. Then that evening, we have what we call a VIP mix and mingle. And the VIP mix and mingle is we like to have fun, and we teach something called multiplexing. Have you ever read Friend of a Friend by David Burkus?
No.
God, it's good. It's really fantastic.
Friend of a Friend.
Friend of a Friend. And it talks about what it takes. And it's exactly what you referred to earlier. We're not just partners. We are friends with a relationship and a foundation. And he talks about how that process actually occurs. And it's called multiplexing. And I'm not gonna give the whole scenario, but basically what transpires is this: in the VIP room and in the VIP community, you will be able to identify people that you have strong roots with, like even just in our, you know, us getting to know each other. We both have French Canadian heritage, which, by the way, for the rest of you who don't know, that means we're weirdos, and we're lovable weirdos.
Lovable weirdos.
Yes, exactly. So there's this idea about building relationships, not just on the idea of, hey, you're an entrepreneur, I'm an entrepreneur, we should both make money, that'd be awesome. That is not enough for a relationship in any way, shape, or form. So anyway, we go through that entire process. And then we have these 3 days of combination training and networking and joint venture invitations. And I am incredibly proud of our program because we do, frankly, more training than any other JV organization I've ever seen in terms of the fundamentals of how we do this. And we really break it down into 3 areas. Based upon your stage of business, you need to know what to do, the specifics of the what's. So, you know, we talk about community building, we talk about our tech foundation, we talk about list building, we talk about creating offers that convert, and we talk about partners. And those 5 areas have to work in concert. And most of the time, gang, if anybody's listening, it's like, I tried joint ventures and they didn't work. Well, I will guarantee you, they didn't work because you did not work on those 5 elements in concert.
It's got to have a system. And so that is followed up and followed through and checked all the steps. I mean, I see how important that would be. Yes.
Yeah, without a doubt. So we go through.
The thing is that it's like these JV partners are going to, let's say you just have, I'm going to give an example of this and go back to it. You have a webinar coming up. Okay. And now that you've got, you normally you'd get 50 people on a webinar, and then you've got 20 JV partners that are push that same webinar. Now you've got 200 people, 300 people, whatever it is. How do you think your sales are going to increase? Very easily. You do the same thing. You don't change what you're doing. You just invite people to invite other people. Correct. And that magnifies. It's a numbers game, really. A numbers game with the right people. So that's why it works faster. Yes.
A great filter and a numbers game. And that is exactly what we do. So we do the what, then we do the how. And lots of times, you know, lots of trainers say, this is what you should do. But we actually spend the 3 days holding your hand with the how. For example, we craft a specific JV invitation and help you create a JV one sheet. We set up what we call and teach you how to do what's called a partner signup page to eliminate friction in the registration process and get the information that is necessary. We help you set up a resources page so that you actually have a built-in system so that you've got all of your, let's call them trusted advisors and tools organized in one spot for your community so that when they're going to use them, and they will because you said so, you actually get paid. So we go through all of these things of the how, and you practice your joint venture invitation about 100 times. Just to be clear about this, this is not just training. We teach you the what, the how, and then it's like, great, you're going to go do it. We do a multitude of these small groups, by the way, which are incredibly well managed. I don't know if you've ever been to some of these live events where they send them into small groups, and it is a fiasco on wheels because there's 4 people who don't want to say a word and 1 person who won't shut up. And it's like, that was a waste of my time. So we actually train community members to facilitate those groups.
Perfect.
And so everybody, number one, gets their time. It is incredibly well managed. It's incredibly well directed. And everybody gets feedback about what is working and not working about their JV invitation. So that's the how. And then sort of the on the silver platter, this is the thing that, honest to God, anyone who is a thinking entrepreneur should change their schedule and get their ass to JVology, because this is the most important part. And then on a silver platter, we give you the who. Our organization has been around since 2017, serving, supporting, selecting, building relationships with some of the smartest, most brilliant human beings on planet Earth. And if you show up, you follow the process, you live our two values, then the who comes to you. And that's a damn good thing.
So if you're listening to this, the podcast, you're going, okay, it doesn't even matter what you're investing. All you care about is return on investment anyways. He's giving it a special gift because we're JV partners on this, actually promoting this event. This is one of the things we're doing. And you'll see Jay promoting my event when the spring comes around.
Exactly.
But again, it's like supporting one another. You know that this is so perfect for my following. And it's so perfect if you're listening here and you're an expert to have that following. But if you're not in that case yet, you want to be there. You want to go to this. So I think the great part of it is that you don't have to get on the plane and go. You can do this live online and make it work and make it happen for you so that next year you can be doing more things online. You can be doing, and I'm sure that you've had people that actually end up doing events together, their business partners together. It's probably endless.
I have tons of examples, and I'll share just a kind of a cool one. A dear friend of mine, Brad Mooney, his wife is actually in JVMM. I introduced them as well. He and a gentleman named Andrew Resmer did a joint venture with Hippocrates Health in Florida. Now, neither of them own Hippocrates Health. This was just one of those things. As we were working together, they were at one of our high-end JVology summits and trying to think about what would be some of the best uses of our network and our abilities. Now, they put together a series of launches. Please hear this. Over $1.55 million out of three launches on the front end that rounded up to about $2.4 to $2.6 million on the back end in terms of the upsales. And they didn't even own the organization. They just cut the deal to bring the network together. Mm-hmm. Those kinds of things happen all the time. Karen McGregor stood at one of our JVology summits and said, I want to be a Wall Street Journal bestseller. And we organized a support around that process. And 7 months later, there she was.
Yeah, because people don't realize that. They're going, oh my gosh, New York Times bestseller. Well, how do you think people do this stuff? It's JV partners that promote it. It's not one person doing it all. 100%. Or some of them aren't even that great of books. They're like, okay, it was a good book. I remember one I just promoted recently. It was a good book, but I didn't get all the way through it, but it was New York Times bestseller, but it was the partnerships. It was that. Yes. So the power of this most definitely. So where do we go and sign up for JVology or find out more about it as people are listening to this?
So they can go, to get that special price, just to be clear about it, they would have to use your link. So
that'd come to me.
Yes. So the short version is, if you go to the website right now, you're going to see that it is in our middle pricing at $747 for a regular ticket. So you can go to jvologylive.com and see what I'm telling you is how it is. You'll see umpteen testimonials and stories about what people have created through the process. And you get a flavor for what it looks like. There's a great little video there. But to get the special offer, you need to go through Debbie's link. And is that something that I should just send elsewhere or...
Yeah, send it to me directly and we'll get it out to everybody. Awesome. So the sooner I get it, the sooner I get out to it. And if you're listening to this at another time, I want to make sure I spell this right. So you go to the websites, JVOLOGY.com. Okay, so we're going to go, you're going to get it, or you're going to get the link for me.
Debbie, for the event, it's JVology Live, L-I-V-E.
Okay, sorry. JVOLOGY.com.
You betcha.
It is .com, even though you're in Canada. Okay. So it doesn't matter. We're worldwide. And so there'll be probably hundreds of people on that call, probably from all over the world.
So we average it and it goes up and down and in and out and all those sorts of things. But we average around 100 people at that event. And here's one of the pieces about this. I want to just really urge folks to actually show up and attend because I'm going to be a bit of a judgmental ass for a brief moment. Okay.
That's okay. That's how we learn.
So the beauty of being at home and being able to not get on a plane, train, and automobile is that we can be at home. The terrible part about it is that people then are multitasking. They're taking care of the cat, the dog, the kid, the lunch, yep. the supper, the, all those sorts of things. So here's the honest God truth about this, which is if you're going to do this, this is not just a training. And in your head and heart, I want you to be perfectly clear about this. If you're going to attend this, you attend this. And I urge people to truly, genuinely think about this from this perspective, is that I'm at a relationship building joint venture training. It's very difficult to build a relationship if you're not there with your camera on, engaged, participating, doing the joint venture invitations and showing the hell up.
Right, so, speaking, interacting, making connections.
Yes.
Huge, yes.
Yeah. So do not spend the $97 and say, I'm gonna listen to Jay in the background. By the way, you'd still get $1,000 of value, but you won't get partners. And right, you frankly bring down the value of the quality of the training. So I'm a bit of a hard nose about this because
no, it makes sense. Totally. You know,
what's happened is we have hundreds of people register and then, you know, not everybody's there. And it's like, sure. So, and by the way, that is a great filter for saying over my dead body, will I have JV with that? They can't even show up to the goddamn training.
That's so true.
I've had people say, it's like, hey, I was at the training. I'd like to JV with you. It's like, no, you were there a third of the time.
Just came down there and wrote out all the names and looked you up online. You know, like, no, you got to create the relationship. You have to have a conversation. So that's really getting on the success track. You mentioned something about success track early before we got on the call. And is that the five steps that you mean is like, as far as really knowing how to do this effectively?
Yes. One of the core pieces of content that we teach the framework of early on day one, and then we continue to work on it throughout the entire 3 days, is we call it the joint venture success wheel. And it is this, the core of the wheel is the community. Everything goes around the community. And then we help people figure out what their tech foundation is. And by the way, that is based upon stage of business and ability. Don't just be sold some, you know, anyway, there's a lot of selling going on in the tech space right now. We'll help you filter the BS from the truth. So your tech foundation.
Yeah. Right. You can waste a lot of money getting things you're not going to use. Yeah. Yeah.
I get it. And then of course we go through community and then we work on list building. And right now list building is incredibly challenging. Email deliverability is at an all-time low in the history of email. And the good news and the bad news, the good news is that there are ways to navigate our way through it. The bad news is you must become multi-channel, and we'll teach people based on where your clients are, who you're working with, all the rest. What are those multi-channels? So do you need to lean on SMS? Do you need to actually have physical addresses? Are you going to just utilize email? If you're going to utilize email, how do you make sure you get the real email? So we'll go through all those pieces and processes. And then of course we help people frame an offer that converts. And by the way, when we say an offer that converts, that could be a one-on-one, that could be a webinar, that could be a live event, that could be any of those sorts of things, but you need to figure out what yours is. And of course, all of this, when those pieces are in place, you are a freaking magnet for partners.
And I love that, freaking magnet for partners, yeah.
It's like, it truly, it's like a fly to honey.
They're coming to you. It should be easy. And you know, when it works right, it is easy. But you got to learn the skills, you got to learn the system, and you've got it down, you got it nailed, you got this system. I'm going to be a JVology. I'm excited to share it with my community. I'm so thrilled to have you here, Jay, and to continue to work together and support each other. So we'll get that all connected. I'll get this out to my community. And any final words you want to share on this podcast?
I think that the final piece is this. Over and over again when people, and by the way, I understand 3 days is a significant time commitment. I'm asking a lot. I really, really am. But I'm going to give you a hell of a lot more. But here's the juggling trick that people have to go through is that most entrepreneurs are challenging their business because they don't have enough resources. They don't have enough time. They don't have enough money. They don't have enough partners. They don't have their technology set up. They don't have a good enough return off their ad spend. They don't have enough. There is a shortage of resources that the entrepreneur's job is to juggle. I want to leave you with one thought, which is this. None of you, in reality, have a shortage of resources. The story you're telling yourself about not enough time, not enough money, not enough conversion, not enough support, not enough team, not enough staff, you actually don't have a shortage of resources. What you have, my friends, is a shortage of joint venture partners, because every single resource you require is available to you through a win-win collaboration with a joint venture partner. And if that doesn't land as truth for you, you need to get your ass to JVology Live. And if it does land as truth for you, you need to get your ass to JVology Live, because we'll give you a whole bunch of those partners on a silver platter.
Yeah. So bottom line, get your ass to JVology Live. I got it. Awesome. We're going to do that. So Jay, what a pleasure. Jay Fiset, my new friend, my new JV partner. I'm excited to be working with you and supporting you on all of your new ventures that you're going forward and playing in the sandbox together.
Thank you, Debbie. And I look forward to supporting and serving you. And I think this is going to be a really great match made in heaven for both of our communities. That's going to be a real strong position for both of us.
Most definitely. Thanks again.
Thank you.
Thanks for listening to Access to Experts podcast with Debbie Allen, the expert of experts. You can also watch our podcast videos at debbieallen.tv. For more information about your host, visit us at www.debbieallen.com. Remember to subscribe.